Welcome to the party on BBC Two. Would you like a gin and tonic? We're all having one.
Welcome to Abigail's party night.
Yeah.
I've got very beautiful lips.
Yeah.
Hey, Tom, do you fancy having a little dance?
Yeah, don't worry.
Yeah?
He's fantastic, isn't he?
Oh, Tony, isn't it beautiful there?
The design does alter.
Well, perhaps you'll have him a little bit later on, then.
Okay. Take another one, Sue. Save me coming back.
Sometimes I drink lager and lime. When you're
laying so close to me. Welcome to Abigail's Party Night. 1977 was a very special year. Queen Elizabeth celebrated her silver jubilee.
That is fantastic!
And punk took off.
She hasn't got a pink streak in her hair, has she?
Bruce Forsyth was the biggest star on the telly.
The gorgeous, the lovely Anthea Redford.
Oh, what a lovely dress.
Beethoven made it to the hit parade.
Darling, not classical.
Light classical, just as a background.
House prices rocketed.
Now that's really great.
But British Leyland went on strike.
Won't the car start?
No.
Most importantly, 1977 was the year in which Beverly decided it was high time she invited her neighbours round for a little drink.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers. Cheers.
On the 1st of November 1977, Mike Leigh's play of social manners and rampant class snobbery burst onto our screens.
A little cheesy pineapple one, sir. Can you take a little bit of criticism?
Now, go on, Sue. Have a little dance with Lawrence. Go on, enjoy yourself. Have a little dance. Go on.
Just because a picture happens to be erotic, it doesn't mean it's pornographic. Oh,
shut up, Beverly!
It started off as improvisation, but in the 20 years since, it's become a set piece. The play has been performed an estimated 20,000 times, and 500 actresses have held court as Beverly, the hostess from hell. So what's in Abigail's Party Night? Coming up in Funny Women, a profile of Alison Steadman, the mother of all Beverlys.
The first improvisation I ever did as Beverly, I had this image of her that she was a woman who enjoyed her body, enjoyed her looks. Beverly was based on an Essex lady that I met.
Then a little party nibble as pundits speculate what the world of Abigail's party would look like today.
If she was dressing now, she wouldn't want to do a 90s version of the 70s. She'd want a very up-to-date look, albeit very sexy.
Then at 9:30, there's the play itself.
How do you do? Pleased to meet you.
How do you do?
It's got a firm handshake, hasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, fantastic. Like to come through?
Why I was not invited?
So that's Funny Women, followed by a party nibble, Abigail's Party at 9:30, another nibble, then Demis at 11:15.
Bev is an icon of 70s style, although of a very particular type. The dress she wears in the original, this kind of hideous orange thing with the plunging neckline and all the frills, is very Sarbanthia Redfern. It's the kind of hostess trolley of the fashion world, really. And of course, Bev has her own beauty tips. She loves the lip gloss. And interestingly, of course, lip gloss is back in, but Beverly wouldn't be wearing it now. If she was dressing now, she wouldn't want to do a 90s version of the 70s. She'd want a very up-to-date look, albeit very sexy. So I think she'd probably have a leopard skin body, again, very, very sexual. PVC trousers, because she is so tactile, and some gold somewhere. I think the really worrying thing is what she'd do to Lawrence, because you just know that she'd force him into Calvin Klein underpants, whether he liked it or not.
In the play, we have this wonderful group of fledgling, innocent consumers feeling their way. Mine's better than yours, mine's bigger than yours. And obviously, the subject turns to cars, because by that time in the 70s, we were beginning to measure the importance of our cars by the length of their bonnets. And we've got Mini versus Escort. Now, Tony's Escort, very bright and strident in Daytona yellow, and he's got a long bonnet. But Lawrence's Mini has a very, very small bonnet, which is why Bev gives him such a hard time, because there's a thinly veiled reference to his masculinity. But if you turn it all round, in the 90s, the wheel turns full circle. Tony's escort is out, big time. The 90s equivalent of that would be the escort, and it would probably be one of those hateful escort convertibles driven by some lowbrow thug with a neck like a birthday cake. But Lawrence's Mini is in, big time. It's trendy, it's bright, it's lively, it's cheeky. He could change it for a Fiesta XR2, but that would be to blow the whole thing. He should stick to the Mini because he has that rare, that wonderful thing, the classless car.
You're watching Abigail's Party Night on BBC Two.
I've got very beautiful lips.
Yeah.
Hey, Tom, do you fancy having a little dance?
Yeah, don't mind.
Yeah?
He's fantastic, isn't he?
Oh, Tony, isn't it beautiful there?
The design does alter.
Well, perhaps you'll have him a little bit later on, then.
Okay. Take another one, Sue. Save me coming back.
Sometimes I drink lager and lime.
In a moment, the play itself. Later on Abigail's Party Night, the life and times of Bev's favourite Greek dish, 70s pop star and caftan... Yeah. You're watching Abigail's Party Night on BBC Two.
I've got very beautiful lips.
Yeah.
Hey, Tom, do you fancy having a little dance?
Yeah, don't mind.
Yeah?
He's fantastic, isn't he?
Oh, Tony, isn't it beautiful there?
The design does alter.
Well, perhaps you'll have him a little bit later on, then.
Okay. Take another one, Sue. Save me coming back.
Sometimes I drink lager and lime.
This is Abigail's Party Night. In a moment, King of the Caftan, Demis Roussos. But first, just to jolly things along, a party novel.
Do you want a little cheesy pineapple one? Yeah.
But poor old Beverly. I mean, she's just the latest in a long, distinguished line of theatrical social climbers, and that stretches back hundreds of years. So I'd say to you, Bev, hey, just chill out a little. You didn't do so bad. And I saw you put that Beaujolais in the fridge, by the way. Well, I'd do just the same. Chill it down for an hour. Any expert would do that. Oh, and those little lovely, cheesy, wheezy, pineapple-y things. Mm. All the Bevs of today are still serving those. I mean, it's retro food, the nibbles that time forgot. I love them.
There's a really good persistent use of brand names and place names and the names of artists such as Demis Roussos, which is rather like the brand name snobbery that you get in James Bond. There, Ian Fleming uses various items to demonstrate how sophisticated, how worldly, how smooth Bond is. Here, Lee and his cast use these things to condemn.
Please, I want to ask you a question. Who is this Abigail? On what is this Abigail's part in, and why I was not invited?
You've been watching Abigail's Party Night. Thanks for joining us.